Praise the Lord, friends. Welcome back to Spiritual Morsels. In the last episode, we saw about a person who was cursed by his mother, Jabez. In today's episode, we are going to look into the life of a person who was cursed by his father. We know in the book of Genesis chapter 49, towards the end of his life, Jacob calls all his children forward and he tells them, "Come unto me and I am going to tell you what is going to happen to you in the later days." What he actually meant was, you see, they were in Egypt at that time, and before he died, he called them to bless them. But he knew that after his death, Joseph will die, and after Joseph's death, a king will come who would not be knowing Joseph, who would make all his children slaves. So he knew that his children are going into slavery. So he tells them, "I'm going to tell you things that are going to happen to you in the later days," not anytime soon, but later on. And so Jacob starts blessing them one after the other. But when he reaches two people, Simon and Levi, he pauses. He starts cursing them instead of blessing them. He tells them in verse 6 and verse 7. In verse 6, he says, "O my soul, do not gather in their assembly." In other words, he's telling his other children, the rest of his children, don't go to their assembly. In other words, when they have fellowship, don't have any kind of fellowship with them. A curse of loneliness. His father has proclaimed a curse of loneliness over Simon and Levi, both of them. Later on in verse 7, we see there's another curse. The father says, "I will scatter you in all Israel. You will have no inheritance in Israel." And so, just like Jabez, Simon and Levi are carrying this curse upon their shoulders and going ahead in their life. And they pass it on from generation to generation. But later, Moses comes and he takes the Israelites out of Egypt to the promised land, Canaan. And on the way, when we reach Exodus chapter 32, we see that something very interesting happens there. The entire nation of Israel forgets God and they forget Moses and they start worshiping a golden calf. They look at the calf and they say, "This is the God who brought us out of Egypt." And Simon joins the rest of the Israelites. He might have thought to himself that, "Well, when I gather an assembly, they are not going to join me. I might as well join them." And so Simon also joins the rest of the Israel and they all worship the golden calf. But we see in verse 26 that the Levites take a step back and they just watch these people. They say, "We are not going to worship this golden calf. We know that the living God of Israel is the one who brought us out of Egypt. I'm not going to worship this calf. It doesn't matter. Though none go with me, still I will follow." He started singing that song. He started standing alone for Christ, for God. And in verse 26, when Moses comes down from the mountain, Moses sees that the Levites are the only group of people who stood for God. And that day, God changes the story of the Levites. Every ordinance that was written against them, everything that was contrary to them, the handwriting of ordinances that was against the Levites, God changes into a blessing. What was the curse that his father proclaimed over him? If you remember Genesis 49 verse 6, his father said, "O my soul, do not gather in his assembly." We see in Deuteronomy chapter 33 verse 10, God tells Moses to call the Israelites and tell them, "Whenever or wherever you gather an assembly, call the Levites to teach you." The curse is that the Levites will be left alone. They will be lonely. No one will come to their assembly. God says, "Okay, don't worry. No one will come to your fellowship. I will make sure that when they have a fellowship, you will be called there. You will be given a special invitation to go there and teach them." God turned it around and made it a blessing, an amazing blessing. The next curse in Genesis 49 verse 7, we see Jacob says that I will scatter you all over Israel. You will not have any inheritance. In Numbers chapter 18 verse 20, we see God telling the Levites, don't worry. Did your father say you will not have an inheritance? I am your inheritance. It's okay that you will not have an inheritance in the entire land of Israel. I am your inheritance. Such an amazing blessing. And it doesn't stop there. You see, when his father proclaimed the curse saying you will not have an inheritance, you will be scattered, which means that he will not have an allotted portion of land for himself like the rest of the tribes. But God does something really amazing. When we read Joshua chapter 21, you study the entire chapter and we see God telling all the Israelites that wherever you are placed, you all have your own allotted portions. Do one thing, build cities. And when you build cities, 48 cities are to be separated and kept only for the Levites. Whenever a Levite wants to come and live in any of these cities, he can come and stay wherever he chooses to stay. Such an amazing blessing. The father cursed and said that you will be scattered, you will not have anything. God said, don't worry, you will be scattered, but in a good way. You can go and live wherever you want. Such an amazing turn of events in Levi's life. It doesn't stop there. You see, when people have their own allotted portion of land, they get to work in their fields, they get to grow their own food. And so, perhaps the Israelites, some of the tribes were in a place where they had plenty of grapes, some lived in a place where they had plenty of olives, plenty of figs, some lived in a place where there were plenty of pomegranates or dates. And they might be thinking, well, the Levites don't have a land of their own, they don't have an allotted portion of their own, so they don't get to enjoy all this goodness. God said, wait, in Deuteronomy chapter 18, God tells all the Israelites that whenever you work hard in your field and you get the fruit of your hard work, bring the first fruit of everything to the Levites, whether it be grapes or olives or figs or dates, whatever grows, wherever in Israel, the first fruit will be brought to the Levite. You see here, the Levite doesn't have a land of his own, but he gets to enjoy the produce of the land that grows all over Israel. Such an amazing blessing. Dear friends, we must understand, all because he was ready to pay a price. He stood for the Lord, though he had to stand alone. Though there was no one to give him company, he started singing, though none go with me, still I will follow the only living God. My dear friends, we must understand that many times in our lives, for the sake of the gospel, we might have to stand alone. Many times, people, our own friends and family, might not be able to stand with us. And they might not be able to agree with the decisions that we have to make for the sake of the gospel, for the Lord. But we must understand, when we do that, we serve a Lord who will honor us, the Lord who changed the curse of Levi into a blessing. I'm sure will change every curse that comes your way. He will turn it around into a blessing if we stand for him. No matter what, I pray that God gives you the strength to do that in the coming days, and that every curse that comes your way will be turned into a blessing. Amen. God bless you.